Today, we are answering the question, how do I maintain my pool in the winter if it's not winterized? This is part one of a series, and this episode is on winter water pool chemistry. Even though we aren't swimming, it is still critical that we do maintenance on our swimming pools. I see more damage done to pools in the winter than any other time of year due to neglect. We still need to be testing pH and alkalinity weekly and adjusting as needed. Hopefully, you have a basic understanding of water balance and LSI, or the Langer Saturation Index. If LSI gets high, water will dump metals and calcium, which can stain or damage your pool, surface, and equipment. If water LSI gets low, the water will dissolve and erode materials in your surface or equipment, which can cause permanent damage. pH and alkalinity are the two factors in the LSI that most frequently need to be adjusted to maintain proper water balance. Other typically slow-moving factors, calcium, total dissolved solids, stabilizer, need to be tested and monitored at least once a month so you can properly calculate your LSI. Water temperature needs to be monitored weekly. Many people don't realize that for every 10 degrees in water temperature loss, the LSI drops 0.08 or 0.09. So a 30 to 40 degree water temperature drop can be significant on your LSI. You may need to adjust your pH or alkalinity up slightly to compensate for this drop. But remember, when the water temperature starts climbing again in the spring, the LSI will begin to climb again, so adjustments in the other direction may be necessary. Now I want to discuss sanitizers in the winter. When water temperature gets below 70 degrees, most algae starts to become dormant. You're still getting organics and algae in the pool, but they aren't near as much of a problem because they aren't multiplying. We still need to oxidize these organisms, but we don't necessarily need a constant high chlorine residual to oxidize them as soon as they get in the pool. What we do in the winter is we get off of stabilized chlorine, no more tabs, and we superchlorinate every week 5 to 7 parts per million with a non-stabilized chlorine shock. That could be liquid chlorine or it could be calcium hypochlorite. This would generally wipe out any algae that got in the pool, and the algae isn't multiplying much, so it works great for us. If you use stabilized chlorine during the summer, high stabilizer levels can become a real problem over time. This method that we use in the winter helps us lower stabilizer levels over the winter, and the stabilizer becomes much easier to control year after year. If you have a saltwater chlorine generator, you need to monitor your chlorine levels weekly. It is easy to overchlorinate the pool if you aren't monitoring it. As the water gets colder, less chlorine is needed, so you will be adjusting the generator down as the water gets colder. Once the water temperature gets in the low 50s, most chlorine generators will shut down, and then you need to start superchlorinating every week to 5 to 7 parts per million until the chlorine generator starts working again. I hope these tips help you with your pools. Please subscribe to our channel and like and comment on our content. This really helps us get these tips out to others. Be sure and watch for other parts of this series and check out all of our other content.